Hello everyone, welcome to Students Point. This is 28th of March and we are going to see all of the important questions for the entire week. So be attentive till the end. And to get the updates of all these videos, you can join us on Telegram by writing the channel's name, Students Point. You can also follow us on Instagram by writing the username, The Students Point. And if you find the video useful, then don't hesitate to like the video and do share the video with as many friends of yours. Also do subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to receive the notification of all these videos. So let's begin. But first everyone has to answer one question in the comment section. The question is 2001 F032. Hali mein news mein tha. So this is an. These are the options. Read the options carefully and then answer it. Let's begin now. The first question. The Great Indian Bustards is categorized in IUCN Red List as. So this has been categorized as critically endangered. Many times we have seen that this bird is the state bird of state of Rajasthan, and it has been categorized as critically endangered as its number is reducing very rapidly. It is mainly concentrated in the states of Rajasthan and Gujarat. However, few in numbers are also found in state of Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka as well. Why news? Because the Supreme Court has intervened on behalf of critically endangered bird, this bird, over rapidly falling number, and their number is rapidly falling because they often collide with the power lines. Kyun? Because these birds are not able to fly very high. They used to fly at medium or lower heights, due to which there are high chances of their collision with the power lines. As I told you, they mainly habitat in the region of Rajasthan and Gujarat. Why? Because they favor flat open landscapes with minimal visual obstruction. It is also one of their problem that they cannot see very far. Bahut hi short sighted hote hain wo, bahut hi nazdik tak nahi wo dekh pate hain. And they are listed as appendix 1 of sites. The next question. IRENA, that is the International Renewable Energy Agency, in news is headquartered in. So it is headquartered in Masdar City in Abu Dhabi of UAE. So here C is the right answer. See why it was in news? Because it has released a report called World Energy Transition Outlook Report. According to this report, by 2050 there would be 90% of total electricity needs which would be supplied by renewable energy sources such as solar, wind and others, and then it will be followed by 6% which will come from natural gas and the remaining will come from nuclear sources. This body IRENA is an intergovernmental organization. It is mandated to facilitate cooperation and promote the adoption and sustainable use of renewable energy. It is founded in the year 2009 and the agency is headquartered in Masdar City in Abu Dhabi. The next question now, which is the most polluted city according to the recently released report on global air pollution from IQ Air? So it is the city of Hotan, which is a city in China. It is the most polluted city as per this report. It is followed by Ghaziabad of Uttar Pradesh in India. So it is the second most polluted city in the world, Ghaziabad. When it comes to the most polluted capital city, then it is New Delhi. So don't confuse between the most polluted city and the most polluted capital city. I hope everyone will find the difference here. See, this report has found that Delhi is the most polluted capital city. However, India as a whole and most of the cities in India have marked improvement in terms of particulate matter 2.5 when it is compared to the year 2019. So 2020 mein there have been improvement when we compare the availability or concentration of particulate matter 2.5 in air. And India in the list of countries is the third most polluted country. The most polluted country in the world is Bangladesh, then followed by Pakistan, thereafter India. एंड चाइना इन दिस लिस्ट रैंक्ड 11th. दिस शोज डिटेरिएशन इन द एयर क्वालिटी ऑफ चाइना फ्रॉम 14th इन द प्रीवियस एडिशन. इफ़ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर UPSC, CSE 2022 और PCS लेवल examinations फॉर दिस ईयर, देन यू कैन सब्सक्राइब टू दिस प्लान. यू कैन इवन चूज टू पे इट इन टू इंस्टॉलमेंट्स एंड आफ्टर सब्सक्राइबिंग यू हैव टू सेंड योर कन्फर्मेशन मेल हियर एट दिस ईमेल आई डी. ऑल्सो द लिंक टू सब्सक्राइब हैज़ बिन प्रोवाइडेड बिलो इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन एज वेल एज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. यू कैन ऑल्सो सब्सक्राइब टू द कोर्स फॉर इकोनॉमी ऑनली. अगेन यू विल फाइंड द लिंक इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन एंड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स अबाउट गुरु चेमान चेरी कुन्ही रमन नायर. सो ही वॉज अ कथकली एक्टर. दिस इज करेक्ट. एंड ही एस्टैब्लिश्ड एन इंस्टीट्यूशन कॉल्ड एज भारतीय नाट्य कलयम एट कन्नूर. दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. सो हियर सी इज राइट आंसर. से ही वॉज अ रिसिपेंट ऑफ पद्मश्री अवार्ड बट ही डाइड एट द एज ऑफ 104. ही वॉज अ कथकली एक्टर विच इज़ अ मेजर फॉर्म ऑफ क्लासिकल इंडियन डांस फ्रॉम केरला. ही प्लेड सिग्निफिकेंट रोल इन मेकिंग भरतनाट्यम पॉपुलर इन नॉर्थ केरला. ही ऑल्सो इस्टेब्लिश दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन इन 1945 एंड लेटर ही इस्टेब्लिश अनदर स्कूल कॉल्ड एज चेलिया कथकली विद्यालयम. विद्यालयम मीन्स स्कूल. एंड दिस वॉज इस्टेब्लिश इन द ईयर 1983 इन चेलिया. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. बाइकाल GBD टेलीस्कोप विच इज़ द बिगेस्ट अंडर वाटर स्पेस टेलीस्कोप ऑफ द वर्ल्ड हैज़ बिन डिप्लॉयड बाई. सो इट हैज़ बिन डिप्लॉयड बाई रशिया इन लेक बाइकाल. लेक बाइकाल विच इज़ द वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट फ्रेश वाटर लेक. इट इज़ लोकेटेड इन साउथर्न साइबेरिया इन रशिया. इट इज़ अ रिफ्ट लेक. दिस पॉइंट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट इट इज़ अ रिफ्ट लेक. इट इज़ लोकेटेड बिटवीन इरकुतुस्क ओब्लास्ट इन द नॉर्दर्न वेस्ट एंड बुरियात रिपब्लिक इन साउथ ईस्ट. इट इज़ ऑल्सो द ओल्डेस्ट लेक ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. सी दिस टेलीस्कोप विल ऑब्जर्व द स्मॉलेस्ट नोन पार्टिकल्स कॉल्ड एज न्यूट्रीनोज एंड दिस टेलीस्कोप वॉज सबमर्ज्ड अंडर 750 टू 1300 मीटर्स अक्रॉस द 4 किलोमीटर्स ऑफ द सोर्स ऑफ लेक बाइकाल. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच आर्टिकल ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन प्रोवाइड्स फॉर सप्लीमेंट्री एडिशनल और एक्सेस ग्रांट्स. सो इट इज आर्टिकल 115. सो हियर डी इज राइट आंसर. सी रिसेंटली लोकसभा हैज़ अप्रूव्ड द डिमांड फॉर सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट्स बाय द गवर्नमेंट. वॉट इज सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट्स? सी ड्यूरिंग द ईयर इफ गवर्नमेंट नीड्स टू स्पेंड एनी मनी विच हैज़ नॉट बीन अप्रूव बाय द पार्लियामेंट, तो वैसे अमाउंट ऑफ मनी को वी कॉल इट सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट्स. तो इसको अलग से गवर्नमेंट हैज़ टू डिमांड फ्रॉम द लोकसभा. एंड दीज आर पास्ड इन एवरी पार्लियामेंट सेशन एंड आर्टिकल 115 प्रोवाइड्स फॉर सच ग्रांट्स. इफ यू हैव फाउंड इट यूजफुल टिल नाउ देन डोंट हेजिटेट टू लाइक इट एंड टू शेयर इट विद एज मेनी फ्रेंड्स ऑफ योर्स. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स अबाउट APEDA. लेट्स सी. APEDA वॉज सेटअप बाई मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. नो दिस इज रॉन्ग बिकॉज इट वॉज सेटअप बाई मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स नॉट बाई मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. इट इज़ अ नॉन स्टेटूटरी बॉडी क्रिएटेड बाई एन एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑर्डर. नो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज अगेन रॉन्ग बिकॉज इट वॉज एक्चुअली इस्टेब्लिश बाई अ लॉ. सो इट इज़ अ स्टेटूटरी बॉडी. सो यर बोथ ऑफ दिस ऑप्शन आर रॉन्ग. सो डी इज द राइट आंसर. APEDA stands for Agriculture and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority. Earlier also I told you that it is the apex body responsible for the promotion of exports of Indian agriculture and processed food products. It was formed in the year 1986 under Agriculture and Processed Food Products Exports Development Authority in 1985. Thus it is a statutory body. Why it was in news? Because recently it has organized the first virtual trade fair टू बूस्ट एक्सपोर्ट्स ऑफ इंडियाज एग्रीकल्चर एंड प्रोसेस्ड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स ड्यूरिंग द कोविड 19 पैंडेमिक. द थीम फॉर दिस फेयर वॉज इंडिया राइस एंड एग्रो कॉमोडिटी. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स अबाउट प्रिज्म आर्किटेक्चर प्राइज. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन अगेन. सो इट वॉज फाउंडेड बाई जे ए प्रिज्म एंड हिज वाइफ किंडे. सो दिस इज करेक्ट एंड इट इज रिफर्ड एज द नोबेल प्राइज ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. सो यस, सी इज राइट आंसर. सी, रिसेंटली सोशल हाउसिंग आर्किटेक्ट्स एने लाकाटोन एंड जीन फिलिप वेजल, हु इज द फाउंडर ऑफ फ्रेंच स्टूडियो लाकाटोन एंड वेजल, हैव बीन नेम्ड एज द 2021 विनर्स ऑफ दिस अवार्ड. Why they were given this award? For their work that reflects architecture's democratic spirit and their commitment to a restorative architecture. Their recognition marks the first time that a French female architect has won this award, with Lacaton becoming the sixth woman to receive the award since it was established in 1979. So she was the sixth winner and the first woman from or French woman to receive this award. See, this award is given annually to honor living architect, and it is considered to be one of the world's premier architecture prizes and is often referred to as Nobel Prize of Architecture. Next, now, which Indian personality has been appointed as the chairman of Stop TB Partnership Board? So it is Harshvardhan, Dr. Harshvardhan, who is the Union Minister for Health, Family Welfare, has been appointed as the chairman of Stop TB Partnership Board, and he will serve as the chairman of this board for 3 years, starting from July 2021. This partnership was established in the year 2000. It is mandated to eliminate tuberculosis as a public health problem. Its secretariat is located in Geneva. The next, now, John Magufuli, who died recently, was the president of, so he was president of Tanzania, an African country. So your B is right answer. He was an authoritarian leader and COVID-19 skeptic. He was a Tanzanian politician, served as the fifth president of Tanzania from 2015 until his death 2021. He was known for promoting misinformation about COVID-19. Now let's see some more points in news. See, Italy has become the most recent country from Europe to join International Solar Alliance. This has been informed by Ministry of External Affairs. The agreement was signed by Italian Ambassador Vincenzo De Luca. International Solar Alliance, you must be aware that it has at present 121 countries, and this was initiated on the initiative of Prime Minister of India and President of France in the year 2015 on the sidelines of Paris Agreement. Next news, Russia hosted the Afghan peace meet on March 18th. The meeting was organized to bring together government representatives, all the involved stakeholders, along with Taliban adversaries. Next news, the Parliament of Spain has passed and voted in favor of a law that legalizes euthanasia. We have discussed euthanasia, that it is related to voluntary death when a person is suffering from a disease which cannot be cured, or when suffering from unbearable pain, then in that condition patient may be given euthanasia. Thus here the end of video. If you found it useful, don't hesitate to like it, to share it, to subscribe. We'll meet again in the next video on Wednesday. Until then, stay safe. Thanks for watching.